The President's Cup regatta to be contested tomorrow. Bert Henderson going to try and qualify himself and the boat. He's off the corner.
Monitoring the radio. This will be the first of three times around. Green flag out.
Detroit Berber. He's in front of the yacht club in his lap number one, walking the sponsors, as you said, going to slide out to that lane number three and a half, making it up that left side, and that's going to cost him. That is going to cost him. He lost power right there. He picked up the left side at about two-thirds or three-quarters of the way through the corner, and then the boat slowed down after that. Cities, and he's part of this team. He's a big part of the team. Not yet on the clock, but Jimmy King about to get on the clock at the 2017 Metro Detroit Chevy Dealers Hydrofest. He is going to go way into the corner here and get a good one down to him. Here comes Jimmy King on the clock.
Griggs presents Miss Ace Hardware with assistance this weekend from TLC Trucking out of Romulus, Michigan. King, he lapped this morning in testing, second quick, 155.445. Running close to the pins, puts it on the hook, working through the Belle Isle Bridge turn. Jimmy King still looking for that first win in the unlimited hydroplane class. Could it come this weekend? The President's Cup. Could it come in the Gold Cup? Brady's got the smoke to it off the turn.
Certainly does. And could it happen this weekend? Oh, it absolutely could happen. Anything can happen in hydroplane racing, and that's why we come down to the river every year to watch this time and time again. But it's Jimmy King right in front of the yacht club. Outstanding boat ride in perfect water conditions. He won't go back deep again. Top on the wheel.
We'll get a time grab, a monitor to the radio. Lap speed for Jimmy King and the Griggs presents Miss Ace Hardware. 155.177 miles per hour. 155.177. Brady looks pretty stout down in turn number one. We'll see if King puts another hot one on the clock. Here on lap number two, it's the turbocharged Allison. Greg's Ace Hardware.
Greg's Ace Hardware, and I was taking a bet with anybody that wanted to up here. Now he's pulling his foot out of it here. I was taking a bet. He was only going to run that one lap, and all of a sudden we saw him blow down into that big sweeper you like to talk about down there. We thought maybe he was going to run a second lap, but I think he's going to bring it home, or maybe he could play around here and do a little timing run if he wanted. He could do two more laps of
you.
Yeah, he is coming to me. He is on his warm-up lap. I was just talking with Kevin Ingrid, and I said, so what happened? And he said, and referring to the 99.9 Leland Unlimited Miss Rock, the comment there was, sorry, I had a lot of people yelling here. Here comes Thompson to get the other guy on the clock. I said, same thing in Tri-Cities? He goes, yeah. And instead of getting the motor tired, we just shut it off. I said, fire? He said, just a little excess oil, excess fuel in there. Nothing to worry about.
Back beautiful boat, the U11. Mr. Giulio presents J&D's Tom Thompson on the clock. Remaining crew members on the 11 include Scott Lake, Ashley Rainey, Ken Knutson, Brendan Hall, Jack, Eric, and Ben Peterson, Colin Rudnick, Brian Hedberg, Mike Parker, Bud Wilson, Aaron Anderson, and Ken Knutson Jr., Brad Luce almost at the halfway mark. This one could spoil that ladder and qualify. J&D's looking good.
I know that's the intention. That's what they would like to do. They'd love to come out. Oh, look at him break into the sun there as he got just to the yacht club. All of a sudden, the sun was on that rooster tail. Nice corner through here for Thompson. Nice and tight. This will be a good one. Come on in, jump. Gets his feet right away. Jeff's got to listen there to pick. He doesn't have a monitor to watch, so he's got to listen. What do you got?
They're going to like it, Brad. Lap number one for the U11. Miss DeGiulio presents J&D's 155.522 miles per hour. 155.522 for Tom Thompson. Thompson's worked his way through the Belle Isle Bridge turn off the exit pin. And Brad, it does not look like he's on.
Yeah, he's out now.
He's slowed. I think they've sent the message. That's that's a good one.
Yeah, I think they'll take that one.
I like it.
I tell you, that is exactly what we saw in the Tri-Cities. He went out and laid down a 155 and every head in the pit area turned.
Looking good in the warm-up lap.
Here he comes. He's going to come. This is not his first lap, right? He's still on warm-up?
Correct.
He's still on warm-up while he comes through the corner, and you put him on the clock, Jeff Arrow. Let me grab Tom Thompson. One lap, but it was a quick one. I'm assuming he was
Mr. Julio prevents J&D. Boone is running outstanding. The crew's working really hard. I can't say enough about our sponsor, Aura crew. We were looking really forward to a second lap, but the wing broke, so decided to bring it in instead.
The front canard?
Front canard, yeah.
And it looks in one piece. I'm assuming you say broke, you mean control.
It's stuck right there. It won't go. I can't move it. So.
Well, it was a good first lap. Get that part fixed. We'll see you again. That was exciting.
That's an easy fix. We're ready to go.
Right there. Thank you very much. Tom Thompson. There you are. Okay, so there you heard it. He was looking forward to another lap, but the canard, he lost control of that one. You got Andrew Tate on the clock.
He's coming to you, Brad. He's blistering the water. This looks to be a good first lap of three.
If that boat's running, it's usually a pretty good lap. This thing is a bullet. We'll see how he handles his way through the corner. It's a good line out about lane two, maybe make it three. Get a drift down now. Check what we got for lap one.
Lap speed for Andrew Tate and Delta Real Track, 158.546 miles per hour. 158.546 for Andrew Tate and Delta Real Track. Works his way through the Belle Isle Bridge turn. Nice even skid fit water for that big left-hand sweeper. Exits the corner, straight and up the rooster tail rises. Brad Luce, he's coming to you. Can he get to 160?
Yeah, he's 1.5 short. We'll see what he comes through. We were talking about it earlier. Is somebody going to flirt with this 160? This might be it right here. Got a lot of air under the boat. Now he settles it down, sets it up. He's going to be tighter on the buoy roll this time. Could that be enough to bring him home down to
160? We'll get a time. White flag is out. They're gonna like it. 160. 740 miles per hour. 160.740 for the E9 down the Real Track. Crew members are Mike Campbell, Dave Arnold, Desi and Brian Gibbs, Seth Parshall, Jason Jurett, Barry Bishop, Terry Campbell, Mark Bissett, Kelsey Campbell, Jeanette Bissett. Brad, you have to run through quickly when he's running hot.
When he's running that fast, you got to talk fast. Andrew Tate knows only one way to drive, and that is fast. And this thing, it's a bullet. It absolutely is a rocket ship. In second place in Seattle, in fourth place in Tri-Cities. Just a rocket ship. Now, can he improve on that? Basically the same line through the corner. A little bit wider on the exit.
Checker flag out, we'll get a time. Oh, Brad, things are picking up in President's Cup qualifying. Andrew Tate, lap three, 161.357 miles per hour. 161.357. Brad, you said it right. It is
Michael Kelly will come down and we'll get him on the clock. I wish you could see the other sight I have right here in the pit area. Standing by himself at the end of the pit dock here, Andrew Tate.
In series.
In front series. And he just might be on the clock, Jeff Everett.
Green flag, J. Michael Kelly and the Graham Trucking. Crew members include Randy Wildcat Dowdy, John Love Walker, Jeff Hot Rod Kelly, Jim Bad Boy Bakke, Brian Hallen Haney, Pat Bandit Berryman, Jerry Baby Cakes Bowers, Justin Jumpin' Ellis, Sandy Pancake Pearl, Brian Proud Canadian Pizak, Kevin Data Rock Stoltz, and Brooke Bass Thumpin' Tyler. JMK off turn number one. Brad, the tail Daniel rises. Can he get to the 160 barrier?
Well, we're about to find out. He's halfway up the backstretch. He comes to that dog leg. The course actually makes a little bend to the left. When they come off the Belle Isle Bridge turn, it looks like they're running right straight into the yacht club. But then the course makes a little dog leg to the left. He sets it up now for the corner here in the rooster tail. Nobody gets through it any better than J. Michael Kelly. Not quite as tight as we've seen him do it in the past, but he's going to work it out. Coming in.
Lap number one for J. Michael Kelly. And Brad, it's not up there where I thought it would be. 152.203 miles per hour. 152.203 for J. Michael Kelly in the U12 Graham Trucking. They need to pick it up by three ponies here, Brad, to try to vault in the second spot currently on the President's Cup qualifying ladder. JMK hanging that right sponson, Brad. He's trying to get more speed this time around.
I tell you, since they have brought this boat out in the Tri-Cities on the 28th of July, on that Friday, this boat has packed a lot of air underneath it. Kelly likes to fly it. You said it. He's picking up that right side. Now he's got to set it down. You got to have the boat settle before you can turn it. Now he's got a better line through the corner this time than he did before. That's why I think it'll be a little bit quicker, Jim.
Faster, but they're not up to the 155 mark. Lap number two for J. Michael Kelly in the U12 Graham Trucking. 153.021 miles per hour. 153.021 for J. Michael Kelly in Graham Trucking, working through turn number one. Exits the Belle Isle Bridge turn. Nice acceleration off the turn, but Brad, right now, he hangs it right sponson again. Half a lap to go here on lap three.
All right, this is it, the third of three laps around the race course here. 2.7 miles for our defending APBA Gold Cup champion, J. Michael Kelly. Just 1 year ago, he walked out of here with the big trophy. He's going to set it up now for the rooster tail. Hangs it on the big hook. Boom takes a big hop, but he's over right back down. This one looks very similar to the line he came through last time. It is Jeff. Give us a final speed, Jeff.
Boy, what a great photo op. He brought it, Brad, right below us here, about 50 feet away, and 154.299 miles per hour. That was the
speed. I'm going to tell you right now, I got a nickel says they did, because Jimmy just looked real strong through the backstretch. He's up here in the corner. He's going to come down here and put it on the clock. It's Jimmy Chang right on the line.
Walks it from side to side. Officially on the clock. Lap number one of three for Jimmy Shane in the Home Street Bank. Crew members for the U1 include Jimmy Gilbert, Cindy Shirley, Brett Rice, Donnie McAllister, Nick Bonansini, Matt Sontag, Richard Dunn, Pat Furnish, Lee Hooten, and Jack Miller. Julie Hooten serves as social media. Mark Hooten, marketing for the Home Street Bank. Shane has worked his way through turn number one. And Brad, I think you answered it right. I owe you a nickel. They're on it.
Yeah, he's on his way. We're going to find out officially this time. But he's definitely got the boat up and running. You can tell the long, low, lean rooster tail. Great boat ride. The boat is light, but it's not too far light. It's not out of control. Now watch him settle it down on the water. You cannot start to turn these things until you settle that front end down. He does. He just like that. He's on the exit. He's looking at us for Jimmy Shane.
Brad, it's a good one, but they got some work to do. Lap number one for the Home Street Bank. 154.411 miles per hour. 154.411 for the Home Street Bank. with Home Street Bank here this weekend out of Seattle. From their marketing department are Colleen Baylor and Michael Brand. Shane off the turn. Brad, he's halfway through this qualifying run. We talked about these points. He needs to get up above 155.
Yeah, he certainly does, and that will be the mission right now. Not necessarily to get to the top, but he would like to break that 155 mark as he flies the right side a little bit, settles the boat down. And because the boat wasn't settled down when he got to the corner, he had to do so. He went a little bit wider. He might actually be a little slower on this one. Jeff, what do you got?
Lap number two for Jimmy Shane, and you won Miss Home Street Bank a touch slower. 154.185 miles per hour. 154.185 for Jimmy Shane, and you won Miss Home Street Bank. Brad, the U1 camp working their final lap in President's Cup H1 Unlimited Hydroplane qualifying. The one camp wants to get to buck 55, maybe 6.
Halfway up the backstretch, this is it. This will be his final opportunity here during this qualifying run. It is lap 3 of 3. It's important that he's got the book set up when he gets to the corner. This time much better. Going to be much tighter this time through the rooster tail. Check this one.
Lap number 3, Jimmy Shane answered the call for the Home Street Camp. His quickest, 157.554.
Absolutely, but the big difference is not the straightaway speed. The big difference is how they got through the corner. You watch these guys go through the rooster tail now. It's about 6 seconds. Step to get them to do that, and then just bucking Bronco around the corner and then straighten them out and then slowly start bringing. The big difference is not the straightaway speed. The big difference is how they got through the corner. You watch these guys go through the rooster tail now. It's about 6 seconds. To it there. He's enjoying it as much as we are enjoying. Well, look at him getting in there. Little rooster tail jumping up there. Good looking run down the backstretch here for Jack Schaefer Jr.
And now Bill Black looking good as well, Brad, down the back shoot in the replica Gale 5. Nice run here by both boats here on this Friday at the Metro Detroit.
Some of this history stuff, and I look down and see him standing to my right. I go, uh-oh, I got to stand up straight and make sure I say this right, because he's got to come over and correct me if I'm wrong. But Oh, gosh, you're right. He's found his way. He's been up on the tower. I've seen him, but he's found his way here to the back of pit row and on the seawall here. Just watching and loving this sight on the river.
Might want to take a look inside that engine. Well, that you guys four, I think Jay and that team might be maybe a half of a nitrous bottle in there. Looks like that tail went up pretty good.
Did it get, didn't it? Absolutely looking for a nitrous bottle. Look at that.
Nice.
I tell you, this vintage thing, and I'll let them get down to the other end. I'll tell you a little story about our vintage run in the Tri Cities, and a chuckle that we had that maybe wasn't a chuckle. It's the U.S. Boy, that's just a beautiful looking hydroplane. Apparently, Jordan Simon is doing good. Tri-Cities, and we had Hanauer's 82 Atlas, we had the 1980 Griffin Bud, and Hanauer's Atlas was driven by Hanauer, so that made it kind of fun. David Williams drove the Griffin Budweiser, Hanauer drove his Atlas, and we also had the 1973 Pan Pack was on the course with Ken Muscatel, and others took the boat out, and their show on Friday was so good. I mean, I went up and interviewed David Williams, and I said, well, you stole the show. I mean, it was that good. Six or seven hot laps, side by side by side, all three of them. And I went past Doug Bernstein, our current chairman of H1, and I said, that was awesome. And he looked at me and he says, I think we need a seniors tour. And I started laughing, and he goes, I'm not kidding.
Working on steering wheel.
I think
Yeah. have Home Streets coming back.
Oh, shit. Oh, yeah. We're going to keep the...